Mr. Parthasarathy, it's very interesting that for almost two decades we didn't have visits between Indian and Australian prime ministers. In the last decade, we've had more visits than we had in the previous two decades. Is that what we should be celebrating in a way today? The fact, as you said, that we are now with Australia in a strategic partnership through Quad, that there is a far greater increase in commerce between the two countries. There are contentious issues like coal, which both the countries need to address, and green energy. But by and large, would you say that that's what we should be looking at rather than the images that I'm playing on my screen of simply the two prime ministers walking with the cricketers?
I think it's absurd to politicize the visit of an Australian prime minister. I was there when relations were so difficult after our nuclear tests and one had to stand up and tell them off. But right now, you know, look at the fact, that's the fact of the past. But look at where it has reached now. You have the prime minister come here. He's on his way to United States. And it turns out that it is convenient for him to be taken to a cricket match. Why not? I mean, Australia is a cricket-crazy country. You're going to build a lot of goodwill there, taking the prime minister there. And I'm not into politicizing everything. Cricket is a game. Mm-hmm. Please treat it as a game. Mm-hmm. And it's a game which our nation cherishes, relishes, which mm-hmm. every youngster Indian likes to play. I played it all my way through college, and I still love the game. And I'd go anywhere, whether or not there is an Australian prime minister, to see a good cricket match with the Indians doing well.
Right. There is an image now that I'm showing, Jai Shah handing over the a picture of the Prime Minister to the Prime Minister. Now, Jairam Ramesh has made a huge issue out of it, saying this is self-obsession. Somewhere, Sanju Verma, you've said, look at all the stadiums named after the Nehru Gandhis. I've even given the example of Bharat Ratna that Nehru was seen to have given to himself. Do you though believe that cricket should be kept apart from this? Why bring in the politicians in the first place? Celebrate cricket with cricketers.
You know, Rajdeep, I believe that, cricket, movies, as we know, Bollywood has been a cementing bridge between India and many other countries, local cuisine. I mean, these are all parts of what we today term as soft diplomacy. And I think soft diplomacy started in full earnest when for the first time, after Prime Minister Modi took charge, he ensured that 21st June is celebrated worldwide as the International Yoga Day. And I think, rather than talking about the lack of honor with the Australian Prime Minister, let's not forget that today India is the proud host of G20, which represents 85% of global GDP, 66% of world population, 75% of world trade. We just relinquished our chair as the non-permanent member of the United Nations Security Council. And out of 192 countries, I remember 2 years back when we were made the chair, 184 countries voted in India's favor. That's more than a 96% strike rate, which shows how popular Prime Minister Modi's policy is, which mixes the best of both.
So you're saying, this is evidence of soft power. Ami Ben Yagnik, did you go and watch the match in Ahmedabad or did you stay away from the stadium?
No, I did not. I am not. I wasn't well, that's why.
Okay. Otherwise, you might have gone, right?
They gave Sardar Patel a Bharat Ratna in 1991, 41 years after his death. Indira Gandhi gave herself a Bharat Ratna in 1971. Nehru gave himself a Bharat Ratna in 1955.
Okay.
And these people have the audacity to lecture the BJP.
Okay.
Please look at your own backyard and get rid of your hypocrisy. We don't need the Congress to give us bhashan on foreign policy.
Okay.
You are an electorally vanquished party. You have no political morality or political credibility left. That's
okay.
The hard truth.
You've made your point, Sanju Verma. Ami Yagnik, I appreciate your joining us even though you're not well. And G. Parthasarathy, thank you also very much for joining me here tonight.